Cognitive psychology is one of the most expansive and interesting fields within psychology. It deals with everything from memory to language, how we think, our perspectives, and even things like our concept of intelligence. It's also the focus of today's video. This is a general overview video, which, if you've been watching this series so far, you know is a video where I just briefly touch on many of the different aspects to a larger topic. If you want to explore individual topics that I briefly mentioned in this video, you can watch some of my other videos where I cover those topics in greater detail. This overview video may be a little different though from the past ones. Basically, this topic is so large that I can't even really do a general overview of it here. There are additional videos on topics ranging from the prototype model, problem-solving strategies, biases, intelligence, and language development. The links for those videos can be found below. Since the topics are so different from one another, and there are a lot of them, in this video I'm going to give an overview of what cognition is and give a basic guide to how it ties into these other topics. Because of that, this video is going to be a little shorter than I usually do for the overview videos. That being said, let's just dive right into the topic. When we talk about cognition in psychology, what we're really talking about is thinking. The way I like to look at psychology is that there are parts of it that are apparent, obvious, that can be observed. If someone is crying, I know that they're crying because I can see them crying. A person's behavior is a great example of something that is visible and apparent. But a whole large part of psychology is the internal stuff that isn't really readily visible and apparent. This is the internal functions of our psychology. The way you think is very personal to you. It has been created and shaped throughout your lifetime, based upon your experiences, based upon your knowledge. Now, of course, you're experiencing things and learning information throughout your life. Likewise, our cognitions are changing and growing throughout our lives as well. After all, the way you think now is probably quite different than the way you thought when you were 15, 10, or 5. Although, I think my wife may beg to differ with me on that. Likely, the way you think now will be very different from when you're much older. However, the new information we learn is usually done through the perspectives of what we already know. This is all encapsulated in what is called the prototype model. It involves people categorizing new information into concepts that a person is already familiar with. Usually, most new information can be added to existing knowledge. Sometimes we learn something so new and different that it ends up forming its very own category. But those moments generally become fewer and fewer as we age. One consequence of this process of learning new information through the filter of our past experiences and knowledge is that sometimes our perspectives can be wrong. When we learn information based on faulty existing perspectives, it can lead to us not being able to clearly see and understand that new information. This ends up leading to issues with things like bias. Bias is a word that brings up a lot of strong associations with a lot of people. To many of you, unless you've studied the topic on your own, the word bias probably makes you think of racism and discrimination. This is because those are forms of bias that we tend to hear quite a lot, unfortunately. You are learning this new information today on what bias is based on those past experiences, which is exactly what I mentioned with the prototype model. Bias is simply errors in thinking brought about from our own personal perspectives, beliefs, and assumptions. Racism and discrimination are examples of types of bias, but bias is much more universal than just that, and it's something that everyone deals with. I'm biased. You're biased. All of us are biased in some way, shape, or form. Being biased is an integral part of being a human, But that doesn't mean it's something that should be celebrated or accepted. Bias can lead to a lot of misunderstandings and problems for us if we don't understand it and learn how to overcome it. One of the biggest issues where bias can lead to problems is when it comes to issues with problem solving. When we're faced with an obstacle, a problem to solve, we usually have the tendency to go back on the way we solved similar problems in the past. Maybe this will work, maybe it won't. But just because we have always done something a certain way doesn't mean it's the best and most efficient way to do it. This, in and of itself, is a bias that we call the anchoring bias. One of the things that's most interesting to me about how our cognitive abilities develop and change over time is that we base a really massive amount of how we interpret the world around us through our ability to communicate. When I talk about communication, I'm not just talking about speech either, but also sign language, reading, writing, and other forms of nonverbal communication. Language skills, in all of its many different manifestations, are critical to helping a person understand the world that they live in. In fact, when you talk about how we grow and mature psychologically and neurologically, it can be directly correlated to our language skills. That's no coincidence. I always think it's funny when I start to cover language in any of my psychology courses because a lot of students are surprised that we're covering that topic, especially in something like general psychology. After I explain to them what I just explained to all of you, they change completely to the point that they thought it was odd that we wouldn't have talked about language in a general psychology course. Of course, not all the topics covered in cognitive psychology are always so clear-cut. When it comes to our concept of something like intelligence, and especially intelligence testing, things can get quite controversial. I actually consider intelligence testing to be one of the most controversial and difficult topics in psychology. Just asking somebody what makes a person intelligent can be very subjective. What is considered intelligence to one person may not be the same to someone else. When you watch the video on intelligence, keep this in mind. As I mentioned, this video is more of an overview of the concept of cognition rather than talking about specific theories as I did in other general overview videos. You'll also see the other videos on topics in cognitive psychology are going to be a little bit longer than others were in the past. It's all just part of how cognitive psychology is a topic that is a lot different from others we will be discussing in this series. If you're enjoying content like this, please be sure to subscribe to my channel and give me a like by pressing the thumbs up icon below. This helps me to continue to expand these videos and provide amazing content to all my viewers. Thanks for watching, everybody.